We are all predisposed to process music. Biology accounts for some culture-general music processing, including octave equivalents, scales with discrete pitches, and preferred tempo ranges. Beyond that, music has important culture-specific features. Biology and culture share the roles of shaping music and its appreciation. Exposure to our culture's music teaches us what to expect and what to listen for. In infancy, neural connections are organized to manage speech, food, customs, and the music that we regularly encounter. If we are immersed in new cultural beliefs and social norms, then our brain's functional organization changes to adapt to it. Here's what we know. 1. Musical enculturation begins in infancy. Once established, the music system that we know well is somewhat resistant to change, and that's similar to language acquisition. 2. Passive exposure leads to understanding the tonality of your musical culture. 3. Basic emotions, like happiness, sadness, and anger, are culture general. They can be recognized in music from other countries, foreign music. Subtler emotions, such as triumph, pity, regret, those are culturally specific, and these have to be learned before they can be accurately identified. 4. Enculturation strongly affects how our music is interpreted and understood. The more unfamiliar the music, the harder it is to process it in terms of understanding what it is conveying. Liking is mediated by cultural distance. That's how much overlap there is between familiar and unfamiliar musical styles. This is a plot of the cultural distance between Chinese and Western folk music. Each point is an individual song. Data points that are closest to the middle line are those songs with the most overlap in their styles. The points furthest away are those that are very different. We see that Chinese and Western music have both shared and unique features and a middle ground of culturally specific but similar components. Processing culturally unfamiliar music, then, is a matter of degree, not of brain location or structure. You saw in the previous video that melodies mirror the way we express emotion with our voices. Happy-sounding speech in most languages uses larger intervals than sad or subdued speech, as does most music. This suggests that the world's music systems are based on universal vocal characteristics linked to emotions. The emerging picture from ethnomusicologists studying the world's music systems suggests that music evolved from the general need to send and receive emotion-bearing signals. Musicians create music to appeal to universal psychological mechanisms, for example, that promote infant care, healing, courtship, and dance. If the link between emotion and melody is universal, then children and adults should be able to categorize unfamiliar, culturally foreign songs according to their intended function. Researchers at Harvard used something called the Natural History of Song discography to collect data on music perception. The NHS is a collection of vocal music from 86 societies around the world, including small-scale societies. Each song in the NHS serves one of four social and behavioral functions: dance, healing, lullaby, and expressing love. The researchers began with a global online experiment involving nearly 30,000 participants. Listeners heard songs from the NHS and guessed how they were used. The results showed that dance, lullaby, and healing songs were easiest to recognize in every culture. Love songs were recognized only slightly better than chants. The researchers suggested that courtship styles are different across different societies, and so our love songs tend to reflect our courtship habits. A follow-up experiment presented the NHS song clips to children, although not the love songs, which they wouldn't know about, and thousands more non-English-speaking adults in small-scale societies like Ethiopia and Vanuatu. The results were the same as in the earlier experiment, showing that even children have developed a universal psychological understanding of how melody is used. Our psychological need to communicate drove humans to invent a variety of expressive technologies, including music and other art forms. Next, we will look at individual differences and how liking forms.